Clues. Today, what are we talking about? Nuketown. What can I think about Nuketown? Yeah, I think it's good. I think it's a good map versus the original Nuketowns. So I've been playing two Nuketowns since Black Ops 1. You know, and I don't know if you guys knew, but Black Ops 1 was made by Activision. Because Activision was the first company to make Call of Duty, I believe. Yeah. So then that's why Black Ops 1 and Black Ops 2 was handed over to Treyarch, and then so far Treyarch handed the Black Ops series. So everyone talked about how great Black Ops 1 was and how Treyarch did it. No, actually that was Activision at the time. So let's go ahead and talk about what I like and what I don't like about the new Nuketown map. So the new Nuketown map, well, it's I would say graphical wise it's decent. I mean, it's not like amazing Modern Warfare looking graphics, but it's like shoot house like graphics, but it's looking pretty good. And I mean by that is graphics are decent, but here's my main concerns with it. First off, spawn points. Okay, there have been so many times I played this game, I spawn in and then there's like a whole team around me ready to gun me down. I spawn with the enemy team, and that has happened to me more than about 15-12 times, and it's so annoying. I would spawn, and then the whole other opposing team would spawn also next to me. And that would completely drive me crazy. There's no way that you can really, you know, defend yourself in that kind of position, and it's kind of stupid. And I've also been seeing people's faces and guns go through actual objects. Like, if they're hiding behind a wall, their body would like phase through the door, so you can know that someone's easily there. And I noticed that a lot going on here, and I thought that kind of took away the little mystic-y fact of it, because why are people phasing through the door? And it kind of gives away the position, because I can see exactly where they are because they're phasing through the wall. Let me know if you have that problem in your own time. If people have been able to phase through walls, I don't think it's a hack or anything. I think it's just because of the graphical issues in this game. Also, I had so much, this game is, Nuketown has been the most laggiest lobbies, because it looks like the servers are not meant to, like, Call of Duty, even though Call of Duty Modern Warfare shipment was crazy, it was chaotic, and I'll give you that. But the thing is that it at least had shipment 24/7 though could handle the load on Call of Duty servers. You had a few laggy servers. I had about one or two my old time playing Modern Warfare. When Black Ops Cold War though, pretty much it's very hard to find a decent lobby in Nuketown that's not having laggy issues. Just like the servers are just not made for all the chaoticness. And then we're thinking like limit school streaks also in the map, because this is such a small map. And one time I had like three different attack helicopters, and I'm just like, this is like, I don't understand. It was doing domination, so there's a lot more time on people's hands, but I just didn't understand how it was it was impossible to even step outside, because as soon as you get mowed down, you can't really do anything, you can't capture any objectives. They should have a limit, like one helicopter per, like, you know, put at a time from each team, not three from one team and zero from another team. This is so stupid. I'm hoping they'll change, but no, they're probably not going to change it. Then Nuketown has also crashed my Xbox multiple times. I hear hustle on the internet, there's tons of reports in Black Ops Cold War breaking Xbox Ones, Series X's and Series S's. So I suggest if you can avoid playing this game on your new consoles, I would advise that. This game also crashed my PS5, and I'm now having to send that back to the shop. Because of the fact is it will no longer come on. I was playing some, I know this is a multiplayer, but I was playing some Black Ops Cold War. A campaign, got done with the mission, I was so happy, I just got done with this hard mission, and then the console just shut down. And then I attempted to turn it back on, it wouldn't turn back on, and then I unplugged the PS5 and plugged it back in, it would not come back on. So, yeah, so now I'm having to send the PS5, it would not turn back on ever again now. So now I'm sending it back away. As for the Xbox though, it has crashed my Xbox multiple times while playing this map, and my Xbox has shut down or either just closed the game. So this game is not optimized for next gen consoles. If you're playing this on an old gen console, I would say that that's the best bet. Play this on your old last gen consoles. I would not suggest playing this on your new consoles, because that might tear them up. That's just a recommendation. Now for this map though, I have to say every Black Ops has a new, this is the only funnest map I like in this series, until they release new maps, and that's not saying much, because of all the maps are pretty much trash for me. And Nuketown is the funnest out of them, but I don't really like Nuketown. That's the problem. Nuketown is the best, in my opinion, out of all the maps in Black Ops Cold War. And I don't like Nuketown. But it is the best out of all the ones that they have to offer. And I don't know why they don't have a lot. It's like they didn't even do anything with this game. They didn't test it. They didn't check out the bugs. I'm just like, this is so stupid. See, I do not recommend this Call of Duty. And Nuketown map is like, it makes me want to keep playing. Because I'm leveling up fast, you know. I'm almost at prestige. And I just, you know, it's something fun. And I like the fact that you can travel your process from, that to zombies, and I'll do a review on zombies soon too. I just haven't gotten to that yet, but yeah, I just want to say that, and I hope y'all had an amazing Thanksgiving too, because you know Thanksgiving is for the family, and I just want to make sure y'all had a fun time but also safe. So anyway, guys, this is Holy Mike at EPG Gaming Studios. Guys, thank you for joining me about Nuketown. Y'all have a good one. See y'all.